the beef?
Where's the beef?
Where's the beef?
The beef is here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States. No.
Thank you very much.
Where's the beef?
The burning unrest in the Middle East is as hot as the desert sands and as old as recorded history. 3,000 years ago, the twin kingdoms of Israel and Judah flourished in the ancient land of Zion. Later, Arab warriors came and conquered, ruling and roaming the desert for hundreds of years.
What is going on here?
The people of Lebanon must have learned that the cycle of massacre upon massacre must end.
The 24th Marine Amphibious Unit from Camp Lejeune, North Carolina, was deployed. The United States presence was opposed by Syria and its ally, Iran. The Marines were therefore perceived as enemies.
But I remember when I knew I was going to Beirut, that I was like running around. I was Mr. Big Shot, you know, because I'm going to Beirut, buddy. And, you know, I'm not all preachy or anything, but, you know, blessed are the peacekeepers, for they shall inherit the kingdom of heaven.
Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. Blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
The Marines are supposed to be peacekeepers, but every day they look more and more like combat soldiers preparing to fight. A big problem is, who's the enemy? With so many warring factions here, it's sometimes hard to tell who's shooting at you.
I don't know if they're, I don't know who they are.
It's a real pleasure to be with so many who firmly believe that the answers to the world's problems can be found in the Word of God. Word of God. Word of God. I'm going to read to you another man's words.
If a man truly believes that God's word is the answer to all problems,
Word of God,
then surely he would quote something from God's word.
I'm going to read to you another man's words.
Instead of quoting God's word, he chooses to quote a man.
Heed the words of an old Scotch ballad. For those defeats that we've had so far, we are hurt, we are not slain, we'll lie us down and rest a bit, and then we'll fight again. Children are not avenged by the murder of other children. With the wounded, with those who had survived, there was the strange job of trying to ease a gnawing feeling of guilt that would slowly surface. Guilt that they... We'll lie us down and rest a bit, and then we'll fight again, fight again, fight again.
We'll lie us down and rest a bit, and then we'll fight again, fight again.
And the Lord said unto me, say unto them, go not up, neither fight.
Fight.
For I am not among you, lest ye be smitten before your enemies.
There was heavy fighting in Beirut's southern suburbs.
Once again, war seems to have solved and settled nothing.
It's It's a real pleasure to be with so many who firmly believe that the answers to the world's problems can be found in the Word of God. In the Word of God.
Ye have heard that it hath been said, Thou shalt love thy neighbor and hate thine enemy.
We'll fight again.
But I say unto you, love your enemies. Bless them that curse you. Do good to them that hate you. And pray for them which despitefully use you and persecute you, that ye may be the children of your Father which is in heaven.